of our web seminar. We are going to have today a double session, as you know, by young researchers. And the first one is Konstantinos Kitsos. That's going to give a talk entitled "The Output Feedback Control of an Underactuated and Underobserved Cascade System of Linear KDV Equations." So when you want, you can start. And thank you for participating in our seminar.
Thank you very much for your invitation here. So I will present to you a joint work with Eduardo Serpa, Zildas Besançon, and Christophe Prier about, as you said, the output feedback stabilization of some types of cascaded linear KDVs. So the KDV, as you may know, the nonlinear case of the KDV equation, the nonlinear version started in, was introduced by Korteweg and Gebrinz in 1895. And it mostly depicts the propagation of waters with small amplitude, especially in closed channels. So some applications of this KDV equations might be in traffic problems, like especially periodic colloidal waves that are described by these type of equations, especially with their dispersion terms. So in this problem, I will consider the coupled KDV equations that might describe some oceanic and atmospheric phenomena, especially when we have some couplings that occur in the multi-component systems, and there are some relations to weakly nonlinear dispersion. Of course, I will present a linearized version of this equation, and I will show you how we might do some generalizations to the nonlinear case up to three equations. So the main problem is that it's difficult to control and observe all the equations. So the couplings that I consider here are only in the zero order terms. We observe the first equation and we control the last one from the left boundary only. But the observation is either localized or in my case, it's distributed on the whole domain, but only the first state is, the first equation is observed. So there are some links with previous works on internal controllability and observability when we have fewer controls or observations. And I can cite these three or four papers here, the most important, but I hope I don't forget some of the, any of them. There's another work from Fernandez Cara, and I will show you later. So the problem of stabilization of 2x2 system has been done via boundary control of the one equation. And this is only possible when we have some dissipation properties. In our case here, of the KDV equations, we need some damping that is not possible when to achieve this damping property when we have just one observation or one control. So for the single KDV equation, I cite these papers. It has been done in the past, either the output feedback control or the stabilization of the equations. Of course, the seminal work of Leon Leroyer and others. I do not focus on these citations now. So I mostly want to show here that when considering two output feedback control problems, in order to stabilize via output feedback, we will need a high gain observer, as in the finite dimension. When we have more general couplings in the one order or the third order terms, the dispersion terms, the problem is more difficult, but I will show you in the end how this can be tackled, this problem. And of course, there arise some links of these approaches with previous works on internal controllability and observability, like in this world of Fernandez Cara, González Burgos, and Luis de Teresa. And let's start from the system. the system of the n in number KdV equations is described by these equations here, where V is a vector. Subscript t denotes the derivative with respect to time, and subscript x, the derivative with respect to x to space. The coupling is actually the matrix A, which is an upper triangular matrix of this form. And B is just a diagonal matrix that, if you check the last equation, it turns out that the last equation is unstable because of this minus one here. So the boundary conditions that I assume as are the Dirichlet ones, so I call them BCA. And the control is put in the last equation, in the last Dirichlet equation, while the boundary conditions B, they have these properties on the second derivative on the left. And again, the control is put on the last equation on the left, but on the second derivative. This is a less classical problem, so it has some extra difficulties, and I will show you why and how I implement a particular method on high gain observer in order to tackle this case, which is more difficult. As I told you, I will show you in the end the case when we have different couplings. Here, as you can see in the one order term and the third order terms, we just have the coefficient, the identity coefficients. But imagine we might have diagonal coefficients of different elements, or we might have lower triangular coefficients. This is a harder problem. I will show you in the end. So the observation, as I told you, is only the first equation described by this equation. But as I told you, it's localized everywhere. It's considered to be known everywhere on the domain 0L. There is a question, what is happening when we consider a localized observation near the right endpoint of the domain? This will be answered later, but so I will show you the case of distributed measurement everywhere. So the observer we use here, it's not a pole placement observer that we would use for linear systems in finite dimension, for instance, but we use a high gain observer methodology, where actually we couple we copy the initial system, and we add this theta k term, which is an output correction term. On the boundaries, we just copy the same boundaries, so we do not change anything at all. And here a minus b is the coupling coefficients. So I will show you how theta matrix and k look like. Theta matrix is a diagonal matrix of gains theta small to the powers of I until n. And k is a matrix that's such that a plus kc, a is the coupling matrix, and c is the vector that is appearing in the output. So because a and c is observable pair, we can always find a case such that this is Hurwitz. So the first theorem talks about the observer convergence. So the observer I showed you before actually converges arbitrarily fast to the state for any of the two boundary control problems A or B. For the boundary control problem named BCA, it is easier, while for the BCB, it is quite more demanding. And the sketch of the proof is the following. First, we have to define a Lyapunov function of this type, where P is an appropriately chosen function, positive function. And P capital is a matrix satisfying this Lyapunov equation, which is directly satisfied. Epsilon is the error of the observer. So we need to find the decrement of this Lyapunov functional. To do this, we use a lemma that we prove. And this lemma says is that for some lambda, where lambda appears here, you can imagine that lambda depicts a damping coefficient For every lambda sufficiently large, there always exists a function p, and b positive, such that this equation 4 are satisfied. What this equation show is that actually these solutions p correspond to the eigenvalues of the KdV operator. You can imagine the KdV operator of the single equation, which is damped by lambda. And it says that some extra conditions on zero are satisfied, and also p is positive, and it's increasing. In order to show that there is always a lambda zero, such that for lambda larger than lambda zero, these equations are satisfied, we will use an approach which is usual when we take into account the characteristic equation of the KdV operator, inspired by Lionel Rozier and other works. So the assertion one says that for lambda, which will be the damping coefficient large enough, these equations are satisfied. And the assertion two says that for lambda smaller than this critical damping, there always exists an L, which is the domain. So there always exists an L bar, which is the length of the domain, such that, again, these equations hold for X smaller than L bar. So for small, this L bar turns out to be very small. So as I told you, to use this lemma, you use a trick inspired from this Lionel Rozier work. So it turns out that L bar is very small, is given by this arctan 2 over 5. And then to continue to the proof of the observer convergence for the Lyapunov function V, for the BCA, we just use P equals 1, and then the observer error is damped by this term A plus KC that appears there, and it can be controlled by the gain theta small. While for BCB, there is some extra terms that coming that needs to choose theta larger than something that, because theta, which is the gain of the observer, plays the role of this lambda that I showed you before, which is the damping coefficient. In order to lead to the negativity of the time derivative of the Lyapunov, we need to choose theta large enough, and that's why we use this high gain observer, showing also that a classical pole placement observer cannot work. So to proceed to the control, as I told you, because of the form of the system, we can easily apply a backstepping control, and the last equation, which is quite, for BCA, it's more classical. For BCB, it turns out that it's written in this form. Omega appearing here is a gain of the controller, and P also, it's a gain, is a kernel function satisfying these PDEs. It turns out for P in this domain, as you may know, it's an old problem of backstepping of Eduardo Serpa has introduced it. Of course, others, but for the KdV, it's Eduardo Serpa mostly. So it turns out that these kernel equations are solvable, and we can always find these controls U for BCA and BCB. So the main theorem of the stabilization of the closed loop system has these main parts. The first part says that for any convergence ray D bar, there exists a control U in appropriate space, L2 space. And theta zero, omega zero, theta zero is the minimum gain of the observer, and omega zero is the minimum gain of the control. and C bar, this coefficient, such that for theta and omega large enough, we have the stabilization of the last, you see here only the last equation, which can be arbitrarily fast. But for the whole system, the whole closed loop system, what we only have is the stabilization, but for BCA, the stabilization holds for any number of equations n, and for every length of the domain L. So the stabilization is of this type. It means that V hat goes to zero, and at the same time, V hat minus V goes to zero, showing that the closed loop system is stabilized. And for the BCA, as I told you, it holds for every n, but for the BCB, this holds only for n equals two. So only for two equations, we can, for every length of the domain L, the stabilization is achieved by this, inequality. And this is linked to the previous lemma that I showed you that says that actually there is a critical damping coefficient for this specific BCB boundary conditions problem B, where we put the control on the second derivative and have these zeros on the second derivative from the left. So at the same time for this BCB, when n, so the number of equations are more than two, there exists a critical length of the domain L bar such that for smaller, this is an upper limit, so for smaller lengths, the stabilization is possible. This is not very practical, but we mostly focus on the B case where we have the two equations. What we use for the proof is first for the single equation, we have a single damped KdV equation of this form. For the first boundary control problem, we just have Dirichlet problem, for instance, zero here it's classical, and two from the right, two boundary conditions on the right. But when we have on the left, on the second derivative, what we saw is this proposition that says that W, the solution to W system is stabilized for every positive lambda, which is a damping, while for the second boundary condition 6b, the stabilization is only achievable when lambda is greater than something, critical value, lambda zero, lower value. But whenever lambda is smaller than this lambda zero, there exists a length of the domain L bar such that the stabilization can be achieved for lengths lower than this length. This is the result for the single equation. It's not a system, it's just a single equation. So we use this result in order to show the stabilization of the coupled equations. So while we need to stabilize the closed loop system, a high gain observer design is crucial. As I showed you, the high gain feature is that we have this matrix theta capital, which is a diagonal matrix of the powers of theta small, which is the gain. This is classical in finite dimensions when we deal with nonlinear systems, but here, even if we don't have nonlinear systems, we will use this technique in order to be able to stabilize the system, especially for the boundary condition problems, problem B, the BCB. So as I told you, for the BCB, we need the critical damping coefficient for the stabilization, as seen also in the previous proposition for the single KDV equation. So imagine for the coupled equations, the same problem appears. And it turns out that this critical damping is linked to this number where A capital is the coupling matrix of dimension n minus one. Our coupling matrix was on the dimension n, so you can imagine a smaller one. And it's given by this expression. It turns out that if we choose n equal two, this minimum, the eigenvalue, the minimum eigenvalue of this row is two. And for this value, we are in a position to prove the stabilization of the closed loop system. In any case, when we have more than two equations, we can again prove the stabilization, even if the damping is not sufficient, but we prove the stabilization for L small enough, for L capital small enough. So now I will show you what is happening when we have different couplings, more general ones, even nonlinear ones. Going back to the works I showed you before, as the works of Christophe Zhang, Fatia Alabo-Boussira, Jean-Michel Coron, and Pierre Lissy, they showed that when we have general couplings, like the coefficients of the differential operators are different, distinct. If we have a diagonal differential operator with distinct elements, it turns out that we need strong regularity of the system. We need to assume stronger regularity. And this is linked to the notion of algebraic solvability. And it turns out at the end, when we do the controllability problem, it turns out that we lose some derivatives. So I will show you some generalization. First of all, I will tell you that in our case, we considered a measurement of the first state, which is distributed throughout the whole domain. But what is going on when we have a localized observation on L minus epsilon comma L, so near the right endpoint? So in that case, an internal observer of this form that I showed you can estimate the state, the whole state, the whole vector of the state V1 to Vn, so the whole system. And if we combine this observer, this internal observer, with a boundary one from to the rest of the domain by using this estimation of the whole vector of the state, it is possible, it is easy to see that the observer, the composite observer, will work for this case. So in the case of general couplings, let's see for the KDV equation, the KDV cascade system of equation. Imagine that we do not have the identities in the terms Vx and the dispersion term, but we have some matrices which are lower triangular, or even in the diagonal case, when we have distinct elements on the diagonal. This problem, we have given some solutions for other types of systems like hyperbolic or parabolic. But to my opinion, we can solve this problem with a different approach, which is again linked to the previous works I mentioned to you, and requires some strong regularity of the system. Again, if we have nonlinearities also in these terms, but also in the zero order terms, especially lower triangular regularities, we have solved this problem for the observer design for hyperbolic systems, but up to three equations. So we have three coupled equations. And it turns out that for more than three, if we have the nonlinear case, we have not found a solution. And of course, we can apply these approaches, the previous approach that I discussed, to some nonlinear inverse problems for partial differential equations. So let's see an example of a hyperbolic system and how we can observe, how can we write an observer for this system. So let's imagine again n equations coupled in this manner. Lambda is the matrix of the characteristic velocities, which is, has distinct elements on the diagonal. And mu is the coupling matrix on the zero terms. Here, I do not consider any couplings on the one order terms, but just on the zero orders, but it's very difficult as a problem. So we do not have any dissipativity for the boundary conditions. We can consider very general ones that do not allow the stabilization of the observer error. So to solve this problem, I will show you very briefly, not all the details. The trick is to consider some index of strict hyperbolicity, meaning that how many distinct characteristic velocities we have. And we assume some strong irregularity linked to this number of characteristic velocities. And of course, that the coupling the upper on the upper diagonal on the sub-diagonal are non-zero. The assumption 3.1 version, we have two versions, but I will show you that only one version is the periodicity. And this is recovered also. There is some links with controllability problems of the work of Alabo Boussira and the other authors. But of course, there is a different version, not only the periodicity version. So to solve this problem, we consider a T transformation, infinite dimensional straight transformation, transform system into another one, into a Z coordinate system. And X is a space of this regularity. So if we write a target system for the initial system V, what we have is a new system where the differential operator is decomposed in the part with one element on the diagonal lambda n, plus another differential operator m calligraphic, which acts only on the first state, but the first state is the measurement. So again, on the boundaries, we have some extra terms, k1 and given by k1 and k2 differential operators. So they include the spatial derivatives of z1, which is the measurement, the observation. And this T transformation to write the system into this target system looks like this T calligraphic, which is the identity plus this T matrix. And turns out this matrix operator, we have to find these T tau small functions. In order to find them, we need to solve this generalized Sylvester operator equation, and it turns out that has solution algorithmically. And these solutions, of course, depend on the number of velocities lambda one, lambda I. So what we have done also is, even for the nonlinear case, because here I showed you the linear case, we have done this for 2x2 quasi-linear hyperbolic systems with a lower triangular hyperbolic operator. So it's not diagonal as before. And also for 2x2 and 3x3 parabolic systems with distinct elements. And for instance, a system that can be written in this case is this system. You can imagine also that it can be a system of partial integral differential equations. We see that lambda is having distinct elements. And then only RTF has this triangular form. And again, the output is the first state. The assumptions, again, to solve the problem of the observer, what I have done is only for the observer problem, not for the control yet. But for the observer problem, we need, as I told you before, strong regularity. I remark here that this strong regularity assumption was not needed for the initial system I showed you, the KdV equations. because the couplings of the KdV equations were not on the zero, on the one order and dispersion terms. So this allowed us to, and the reason why is that the coefficients of these differential operators were the identities. This allowed us not to need a stronger regularity, but stronger regularity comes when we have these coefficients of the differential operator that has distinct elements on the diagonal. So to solve this problem, we also use special derivatives of observation. So this is observation Y, the special derivatives of this. And it is solved via a linear infinite dimensional state transformation. As I told you before, what is interesting here is to show these links of the observer and control design with the developed problems of internal controllability and observability of these authors. And the problems come from the algebraic solvability mostly. And another open problem, to my opinion, is if we can derive an observer or even a control for more than three equations when we have the nonlinear systems. As I told you in these works, in the previous works, it has been studied the controllability of some systems, and there is always a limitation with respect to the number of the equations and also to the types of the couplings. So thank you very much. So maybe some questions?
Yeah, sorry. It seems that America has some difficulties. So I will share. Are there any questions? So if there are, please raise your hand if possible, or just speak. Or if you have a problem with your microphone, you can use the chat. Are there any questions?
Yes, with respect to the KdV equation, you did the nonlinear version of these couplet equations, because I get lost a little.
No, I have not.
The linearized version, no?
I have done only, yes, I have done only the linearized version, but
okay.
That's why at the end I showed you some possible extensions to the nonlinear case by showing that it works for example, for hyperbolic systems when we have one operator, only one part. Here we have the first order and the third order operator. So
I don't know if here I'm just starting to work with these kind of problems with a stabilization at an observer. So I'm not very expert with that, but I don't know if the techniques of fixed point arguments by Takeo Takahashi can be used here. Have you think about that?
You may refer to the observability, right?
Yes. But maybe for a stabilization for the nonlinear system, I don't know, but maybe it's useful here.
Yes,
you
are
right. Paper of Takeo Takahashi?
To me, the most interesting problem is to retrieve links, which of course exist, with the between the observer and control problem and the controllability and observability on which. So this technique, I do not know how to use it here, but especially when we have the couplings instead of a matrix, we have a nonlinearity, possibly triangular, as the one I showed you for hyperbolic systems, how we can solve the observability. That is an interesting problem, I think.
Yes, I don't think for the moment, not the coupling nonlinear, but the equation nonlinear, no? And the coupling, as you have here, I think it's the first idea to study.
Ah, you mean for the nonlinear KDV? Okay, yeah. In this case,
KDV, but the coupling, as you have here.
Yeah. Here, if we had not once the diagonal of the coefficient of V, X.
Yes.
If we had V1, V2, it would be extremely difficult, but I can show that it works if we have just V1. So if we had the first equation, V1 times V1x, the second equation, V1 again, V2x, plus...
Okay, so the coupling with the first component with all the others.
Yeah, only with the first component. This I can show. This is possible. But when we have the original KDV, which is V1, V2, V3, then I do not know how to do it.
Okay. Thank you very much. Very interesting, Konstantinos. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any other questions?
Sorry. I was out. I was off for a moment, so I. But I'm back again. Yes, I have a question here. You mentioned that you can introduce another observations. Which is the how can I say? Which is the level of generality at which you can work with other observations with the in this system?
I believe that because of the type of this cascade system, when we have one only observation, it is not possible to have a boundary observer, this is sure. But what we can have is an internal observer when the observation is only known on a part of the domain. This is the only possible. But this comes from the problem of observability of the system. Because as you know, the KDV equation needs a damping. And if we had the boundary observation of the first state, for instance, we would not be able to map the error system to a dumped system of KDV equations. So the only way is to have a localized measurement. Here I don't have a localized, I have, as I told you, the whole domain, it's easier, but even the localized, it should be combined with a boundary observer. So we would have a composite observer of two parts in that case.
And would it be possible to have observations on several components in several domains?
And sure. In that case, we'd have a different C here, a different vector C. And at the same time, we would have to change A in order to have an observable pair A, C. In that case, it would be also possible, but and maybe it's more practical, more examples from nature. That's a problem that I haven't answered yet. If there are real problems that are described by these equations, as I told you, there is some classification of Penleve, they're called in physics, about oceanic interactions with atmospheric waves. But I don't know in general, in practice, other examples.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for your presentation. Very nice presentation. And we are going to pass to the second one now. And so can you... Please share your slides again. Okay, thanks. The second presentation is will be given by Ezequiel Malia Cepeda. And the title is Optimal Control Problems Related to Chemorepulsion Systems.
Thank you, Professor, for the presentation. In this talk, I will present some optimal control problem related to chemorepulsion model with linear and nonlinear production terms. This is optimal control problem have been analyzed in collaboration with Professor Francisco Guillén González, María Ángeles Rodríguez Bellido of Universidad de Sevilla, Spain, and Professor Elder Villamizar Roa, Universidad Industrial de Santander, Colombia. I also want to thank the opportunity given to me to present my research. Thank you very much. The outline of the talk is followed. First, we present chemotaxis system, in particular, chemorepulsion model. For this model, we present some results related to existence of solution, a strong solution for 2D domains and weak solution for 2D domains. Also, we do the objectives to study optimal control problem. For the 2D case, we establish a regularity result which allow you to improve the regularity of the weak solution. The regularity of the weak solution in 3D domains is few. Finally, we study optimal control problem. For 2D domains, we consider linear and nonlinear production term. And for 3D domains, we only consider linear production. For the control problem, we derive an optimality system via Lagrange multiplier existence result in Banach space. Okay. Chemotaxis is understood as the movement of certain living organisms in response to chemical stimulus. The phenomenon is called the chemoattraction when organisms are directed to regions where there is high chemical concentration, as can see on the left hand side of this drawing. In contrast, if the region with high chemical concentration produces a repulsive effect on the living organisms, they move away. The phenomenon is the chemorepulsion. We are interested in studying of this last model. The mathematical model that describes the chemotaxis phenomenon has been proposed by Keeler and Siegel in 1971. Here we consider omega via bounding domain of RT2 with smooth boundary and 0T time interval. Then the chemotaxis phenomenon is described by the following system of partial differential equations. Okay, system one. Here, the acronym involved are the following. The cell density denoted by function U. This function must be a non-negative function and a chemical concentration denoted by V. This function also must be a non-negative function. System one is an evolution system because appeared the derivative time for U and V. Also, we have two diffusion terms, the Laplacian of U and the Laplacian of V. The chemical concentration and cell density diffuse over the domain. Okay. The term of the right-hand side of the second equation represent the chemical signal production term through the cells. As cells move away, they produce a chemical signal. Okay. In system one, the term more complicated to analyze is the chemotaxis term, given by the divergence of U, Laplacian of B, okay? Gradient of B, sorry. This term make the regularity of the system not easy to obtain. Please, we observe that this term is equal to U Laplacian of V plus gradient of U times gradient of V. And this term is more complicated to analyze. We have said that there are two types of chemotaxis, attractive and repulsive, which depend on the sign of the real constant alpha. Okay. The term alpha U gradient of V models the transport of cells. If alpha is negative, the transport of cells occurs toward the higher concentration of chemical signal. Okay, we are talking about the chemoattraction. And when alpha is positive, the transfer of cells occurs toward the lower concentration of chemical signal. This is chemorepulsion. And finally, system one is completed with initial condition given by U0 and V0, and homogeneous Neumann boundary condition, which are the ideal condition for this system. We are interested in studying the chemorepulsion system with potential production. Here, the function H is replaced by U power P with P belong to closed interval 1, 2. This system has been studied by Cieslak et al. For the linear case, and they prove the existence and uniqueness of classical smooth solution for 2D domains and existence of weak solution for 3D domains. The superlinear production has been studied by Professor Guillén González et al. And they prove the existence of weak solution in 2D and 3D domains. The quadratic case has been studied by the same authors, and they prove the existence and uniqueness of weak solution in one-dimensional and two-dimensional domains. And they prove the existence of weak solution for 3D domains. Also, some numerical simulation have been presented by this author. We recall that our interest is to study control problems related to this system. Okay, and since the solution of the system must be a non-negative function, the standard distributive control is not most convenient, because in this case, we must impose that the control be a non-negative function, which is very restrictive. We want the control to have no sign. Okay. Then the above motivate use to study of a bilinear control problem, which from a biological point of view makes more sense. The bilinear control is a subclass of the nonlinear system of control, where the nonlinear term is constructed by the multiplication of the control by a variable, a state variable. Okay. With this in mind, first we will study the chemical injection extraction problem, which is described by system two. Here, the new term is the injection extraction term. Okay, when f is a positive function, we inject a chemical substance, and when f is negative, we extract a chemical substance. The pros of the injection extraction of chemical substance occur in a control subdomain and denoted here by omega c, which is a subset of the omega domain. Some property that system two satisfy as follows. First, integrating in omega the first equation, we can deduce that the system two is conservative in U. And this in particular implies that the function U belongs to L1 in space. Also, integrating the second equation in omega, we can deduce that the function B satisfies this equality. And in particular, for the linear case, the integral of U power P is equal to M0. Okay. These properties are very important because allow you to obtain energy estimate. And now we will present some results concerning to solution of system two. First, we analyze the system in 2D domains. The result have been obtained in collaboration with Professor Guillén González and Rodríguez Bellido for the linear case, and Guillén González Villamisa Roa for the nonlinear case. Okay. Throughout this presentation, we will use the following space, Stronach space, denoted by xq for q greater to 1. Then, assuming that the injection structure term belong to Ls in time and space for s greater to 2, and the initial data belong to this product space, we can prove that system 2 has a unique strong solution uv belong to x2 times fs. Okay. Also, we obtain continuum dependence of the solution with respect to the data. This constant depends only of the time u0, v0, and control f. This last estimation is important to prove the existence of optimal solution for the control problem that we will study later, because it is key to prove that the minimizing sequence are uniformly bounded in the Stronach space, in this case, in the space x2 times xs. The key for the proof, we will use the Lehrer-Chauber fixed point theorem. For this, we fix an element u bar, v bar maps to uv with uv solving this linear problem. Okay, here u bar plus denote the positive part of u bar. The same occurs with v bar plus. Okay. We need to bound the possible fixed point in suitable space, for which it is key to obtain energy estimate. Okay. First, for the linear case, testing the first equation by Neperian of U and the second equation by negative of Laplacian of V, integrating by part in omega, and taking into account that in this case, the chemotaxis term cancel, we can obtain this equality. The second equality has been obtained integrating in omega and then by multiplying this equality by integral of v. Okay. With this equation, we can obtain energy estimate. Similarly, for the superlinear case, we test the first equation by this expression and the second equation by this other expression, now integrating by part in omega. Also, here the chemotaxis term cancel, we obtain this first equality. The second equality is obtained in following a similar way presented above. Here we detect a problem to estimate the integral of u power p power 2. By using the Gagliardo-Nienenberg interpolation inequality, we can estimate this integral as can see. Okay, but this inequality is only valid for p belong to interval 1, 2. Thus, the case p greater to 2 remains open. Okay. After obtaining energy estimate, we can prove that the possible fixed points are bounded in weak space. In order to improve the regularity of the possible fixed point, we apply a bootstrapping argument via LP regularity result for the Head-Neumann equation. Thus, we can prove that the possible fixed point are bounded in a Stronach space. No, for 3D domains. Here we only achieve to prove the existence of weak solution. Also, we consider the linear case. The nonlinear case has yet not been studied. Okay. The results obtained here have been obtained in collaboration with Professor Guillén González and Rodríguez de Gil. Okay. Now, assuming that f, the function f belongs to L4 in time and space, and the initial data belong to this product space with P0 greater to 1, we can prove that system 2 has a weak strong solution UV. Okay. Weak strong solution because a function u belongs to this space, and we observe that the regularity of this function is few. The function v belongs to this space. Here, the regularity for v is well. V is a function regular. Okay. Also, the pi uv satisfy the this weak formulation for the u equation, and the v equation holds points basically almost every point in Q. Here we detect a second problem, the lag regularity of the function u. Keys of the proof. First, we regularize the system. For this, we consider epsilon belong to open interval 0, 1, and we define the this family of the penalized problem. With V epsilon solving this Neumann problem. We observe that with this notation, the second equation of the system three is an equation of the fourth order. Okay. For system three, we can prove the existence of unique strong solution belong to this strong space via Lehrer-Chauder fixed point theorem. In particular, the we obtain energy estimate independent of the parameter epsilon, and passing to the limit as epsilon goes to zero, one has existence of weak solution in the sense presented above. We recall that the function u is a weak solution and v is a strong solution. Here we detect a problem. Our objective is to study optimal control problem. However, the lack regularity of the weak solution does not allow you to prove the existence of solution to the linearized problem related to system two in a weak sense. In order to overcome this problematic, we establish a regularity criterion that allows you to improve the regularity of the weak solution. Okay. Here, we impose extra condition for the initial data, V0, V0 belong to this product space, and consider UV a weak solution of system two, such that the function u belongs to L27 in time and space. Under this condition, we can prove that the pi uv is also a strong solution and unique. Furthermore, similarly to 2D case, we obtain continuum dependence of the data. Please note that the only the regularity criterion is imposed for function u, which is not aleatory. We recall that function v belongs to L infinity H1 inter L2 H2. And this space is injected in L10 in time and space, which implies that the term f time b belong to L27, which motivate the condition for you, okay? The key of the proof or the regularity criterion is via bootstrapping argument, okay? First, we improve the regularity of B function, having proved that B function is more regular, we improve the regularity of the U function and so on. No, we will formulate the control problem to study. We consider a calligraphic F, a non-empty convex and closest set of LS, and F represent here a bilinear control acting on the D equation as aggregation or degradation coefficient. Then we will analyze the following optimal control problem. Okay, minimize the functional J given in four, subject to the pi UV being a strong solution of system five. Here, UV and VD are a target state, and the real constant gamma U, gamma V, and gamma F and non-negative real and not all zero. Here, R and S are given according to the dimension of the spatial domain. R is 2 in 2D domains and R is 27 in 3D domains. Also, S is greater to 2 in 2D domains and S is 4 in 3D domains. The first term in the functional J is very important. The choice of R for the 3D case is due to the fact that if the functional J is finite, then the pi UV is a strong solution of the system five. Okay. The ideas for this formulation have been taken from Professor Eduardo Casas by the Navier-Stokes system. The existence of optimal solution follows a standard procedure. First, we consider the admissible set given by all function U, V, F belong to this product, such that U, V, F is a strong solution of system five, okay? From the following hypothesis, we can prove the existence of at least one optimal solution, global optimal solution, okay? Either a gamma F is positive or gamma F is zero and the control set is bounded in LS. And additionally, for the tricky case, we assume that the admissible set is non-empty and gamma U is positive. Under this condition, we can prove that there exists of a global optimal solution you have behind the fact via a minimizing sequence and the fact that the functional J is weakly global semi-continuous on the admissible set, okay? In three-dimensional domains, it is possible to obtain that admissible set is non-empty. Indeed, assuming that the control F acts on the whole domain, that is omega C coincided with omega, and the initial data for V, V0, is separated from U0. Thus, we can prove the existence of an element U, V, F belong to admissible set. Okay. Finally, we will derive an optimality system for the optimal control problem. Here we will use a generic result on the existence of Lagrange multiplier. First, the optimal control problem is reformulated. Okay? For this, we consider the following space, capital X given by this product, and capital Y given by the other product, and we consider the vector operator G with component G1, G2, from capital X to capital Y, given by this expression. Observe that G1 is connected with the first equation of the system, and G2 is related to the second equation of the system. Then the control problem is reformulated as follows. Minimize the functional J subject to G on UVF is equal to zero. Here, the hat space are given to focus our analysis on the first two equations. Here, we have homogenized the initial condition. Okay. Then the optimality system will be obtained in four steps. It is important to note that the functional J and the operator G are fretted differentiable with respect to state and control. Then the first step is to prove the regular point condition. For this, we fix an element U hat, V hat, F hat be a local optimal solution of the control problem, and we fix this element in capital Y. And then we say that the local optimal solution is a regular point of the control problem if there exists an element capital U, capital V, capital F belong to these products. Solving the linearized system relate to the state equation. Okay, this system is the linearized problem associated with the state equation. Okay, here this set is the conical hull of F hat in the control set. The proof or existence of solution for the linearized system is obtained following fixed point argument, in particular the Lerche-Auger fixed point theorem. And then, having proven the existence of the Lagrange multiplier, we are now in a position to apply a Lagrange multiplier existence result in Banach space. Here we apply a result given by Sowe and Corsiu. Right? And by virtue of this result, we obtain the existence of the Lagrange multiplier. Lambda hat belongs to L2 in time and space, and eta hat eta belongs to dual space of LS. This is Lagrange multiplier satisfying this variational inequality. Okay, from this variational inequality, we can derive the optimality system. Please, we observe that the Lagrange multiplier have few regularity. Okay, hat lambda belongs to to L2 and hat eta is a function of LP. Okay. Then, in order to obtain the optimality system, first we will improve the regularity of the Lagrange multiplier. Okay. For this, first we analyze the adjoint problem related to the state equation. Okay. We analyze the system six. We can prove that system six has a unique strong solution in this product space for 2D domains and this other space in 3D domains. Also, the Lagrange multiplier are the unique, very weak solution of the adjoint problem. And then by comparing the strong solution of the adjoint problem with the Lagrange multiplier of time above, we can prove this equality, okay? Which implies that the Lagrange multiplier has the strong regularity given in 7, okay? We derive the optimality system. Okay, the optimality system is composed by an element U, V, F, lambda, eta, satisfying the state equation. the adjoint system or dual problem, and the optimality condition given by this inequality. The optimality condition is so-called first order necessary condition. Okay. Please, we observe that the state equation is a forward problem, which we pose a initial condition. The adjoint system is a backward problem because we impose a final condition. The optimality system serves as the base for a numerical study of the control problem posed. Okay. Some reference used here. In this work, jointly to Professor Guillén González and Rodríguez Bellido, we study optimal control problem in 2D domains. We consider a linear production term. And here we study the 3D case and detect the problem of the few regularity of the weak solution. And here, jointly to Professor Guillén González and Villamisa Roa, we analyze the nonlinear case in 2D domains. Okay. Thank you very much for your attention.
Okay, thank you very much for your nice presentation. Very well, we have maybe time for one question or one comment. My comment is the following. Well, my comment and my question is the following. Can you say something? Have you looked at something similar in the case of boundary controls? I mean, one way to act on the system is, as you have said, to act through a bilinear term in which you introduce a production term on V, but there is another way, another natural way, that is to insert a product through the boundary. So, have you looked at this, or?
Here.
Instead of homogeneous Neumann conditions, to introduce a flux of particles or chemical particles.
I have no clue about that. I believe that this problem is more complicated.
Okay. Okay. Well, thank you very much. So we are going to stop now. Thank you for attending to everybody. And I remind you that the next week we will have a talk by Asia Ben Abdallah. So we hope we will see you again in just 7 days. Bye-bye. Ciao.